Welcome back, it's SmashBoss here, and in this video I will explain all the setups that I used in my troll level for DGR. So if you haven't seen him playing his level yet, then go check out his video first, because otherwise the entire level will be spoiled. I will link the video in the description down below, and if you've seen it, then let's start the level. So in the first room, it looks like there's this obvious troll key with two suspicious arrows pointing towards it. However, this troll is just to make you think for long enough so that a real troll can troll you, which are these two cannons right here. So the bottom one spits a spring and the top one spits a Monty Mole. And there's also this spike that you can barely see in the lava. That is needed so that the spring can bounce off the spike and then the Monty Mole can bounce off the spring. And then the Monty Mole will land exactly in this position right here. So all you gotta do is grab the key quickly and then go through the door. So right here, this is already the first technical setup in this level. It looks like you might need the content of this question mark block, but if you try to get it, then the floor suddenly disappears and there's no way to go back after you hit the block. And the way this works is, if we start the level or if we look at it in the editor, we can see that the cannon is actually down here. Only once I start the level, it teleports up to its position where it normally is, and you can see a Monty Mole down here. And basically, the way this works is, first we even need a way to put a Monty Mole and a cannon on the same spot, because normally that won't work. However, if we use the track tool right here, put whatever we want behind the cannon on a track, and then undraw the track again, we suddenly can have enemies behind cannons. So the rest of the glitch with the teleportation basically happens automatically. So right now, this cannon also goes on top of the Monty Mole. However, there has to be a cloud underneath this one, because as you can see, the Monty Mole will of course just fall down, and so does the cannon. But as I said, there's a cloud, so this Monty Mole will stay in place, and there's also this spike, so the Monty Mole that will normally chase Mario can only go towards this wall. And that's already the next part, how does the cannon disappear again. So if I go right here, nothing should happen. And that's because the Monty Mole is still facing towards the spike. However, if I go far enough away to this side, then the Monty Mole starts turning around and runs off the edge right here. And as soon as the Monty Mole is not directly connected to the launcher anymore, the launcher just decides to teleport back in its original position down here. So that's why the cannon suddenly goes away once you jump for the question mark block. So the next trick is the thwomp that is actually completely off screen, so the camera does not scroll any higher, and still it seems like there's a thwomp that is off screen. That's because of this spring right here, which bounces the Muncher up, and the Muncher then pushes the Thwomp off screen. However, once the Thwomp comes down, it will only go back to this position, because normally a Thwomp cannot even go off screen. So that's why once you activate the Thwomp the first time, it will not go back all the way off screen. Then in this pick-a-path setup, it looks like there's one path that obviously leads into a Muncher and two paths where you cannot really see where they go. But in fact, the Muncher path is the only path that you can actually take. And the reason why this works like that is this setup right here. There's a Shelmet and a sideways spring. and as soon as this setup loads, the Shelmet bounces into the sideways spring and then activates the power block. And the reason why it only loads once you actually jump down one of these paths is because of this platform right here, because for whatever reason, things that are placed on top of a platform like this will only load once you are close to the setup, or once you are vertically close. So right here, the distance between this setup right here and the Mario right here on top of these three ways is still too big, so the power block will never activate once you're here. Only if you jump down any of these paths, then the setup loads. And as I said, as soon as it loads, it activates the power block. So then, once you go through this door and come out the other side, if you wait too long, then the same shell that triggers this power will also trigger another trap right here that puts you into this little area. So instead, you have to quickly go there, and then you have to grab this spring in order to go up here. So now it looks like you have to get the star to go through the star maze, and you can technically do that up until this point, but as you can see, there's a spike behind it, so that means you can never go past this point. And the actual way to go right here is to use the power in order to go in the pipe. And then you're already right before the first checkpoint, although you don't know it yet. So it looks like you have to go in this P-switch door right here. But if you stack the power blocks, then suddenly a launcher appears out of nowhere. And this trick basically works kind of the same way as the one with the Monty Mole. Here we have a muncher inside the launcher, so normally it just instantly teleports up there. However, if this spot where the launcher is at the bottom is then filled with a power block or a P-switch or something like that, the cannon also decides to teleport back down. Also, it immediately gets crushed because of this coin, which then turns into a block when the P-switch is activated. So that means you can put two P-switches here without anything that happens, but once you put a third one there, it will always trigger the cannon. So now that you've hit the first checkpoint, you could theoretically have P-switch or even more than one P-switch right here. So in order to prevent you from bringing any of these P-switches, I made this row of invisible blocks right here, so you have to climb up this vine. Then there's this question mark block which has a few coins in it, and if you try to stand on top of it, then suddenly you can load three cannons which will then shoot you. So now, once you go through here, there's a power block, and I guess I made this setup a little bit too overcomplicated. So what I thought that most players would do is just run for it and throw the power block while running, because normally power blocks will then attach to the wall and just fall down. However, if you try to do that in this setup, the power block will just go inside the launcher. And that's because the launcher is on a track. If it would be a normal launcher, then it would work exactly the same way as with this solid wall right here. However, since it's a launcher on a track, things like power blocks and P-switches or something like that, if you throw them towards the seemingly wall, then they will just go through instead. And the reason why this launcher goes all the way from the bottom to all the way to the top is because right here you can only see the middle part of the launcher, so you cannot actually see that it's moving up and down. That means that you may think that it's a normal launcher and try to do this. But instead, I guess, since I placed these arrows right here, most people did it like that, which is the right way to do it. So then, once you're here, if you're curious, you will hit these question mark blocks. So once you hit the first one, a sideways spring appears, and you'll think, well, what's that for? And then you hit the second block, and suddenly everything makes sense. Basically, these blocks have no purpose but to troll you. So all you have to do is just to go in this pipe. Now, you will see this setup right here. Or basically, you will see nothing because there is nothing. However, if you go to grab the flower and come back, suddenly a muncher appeared. So it seems like the only way is to go back into this pipe. Then you'll get into this bonus area where you can get a lot of coins, a 1-up and even a star. However, you can't get back, so that's another troll. But now, how does the thing with the muncher work? This is all a setup with a clown car and something inside it. So right here, as you can see, there's the muncher, but there's also this weird clown car thing behind it. And the way it works is you have to have a clown car and then something. It works with swamps and launchers and maybe also some other things behind it. And then you have to place the clown car in a way that the clown car part of it is blocked by something like this pipe, so that the enemy in the clown car doesn't actually spawn. However, the enemy reaches out one block at the top, so then in order to place something in this position, you have to use the same trick with the track once again, because normally this also won't work. So you have to undraw the drag, and now the muncher is behind or in front of the swamp part of the setup with the clown car, and that way it will not spawn when you load it, when you're right next to it, like when you come through this pipe the first time. But if you go off screen and then come back, then the muncher loads for whatever reason. This also works with other enemies, and it even works with power blocks and P-switches and stuff like that. However, the thing with power blocks is that power blocks will not come back even if you go off screen and then go back on screen. The only way to spawn a power block in a setup like this is to already load it from the side of the screen the first time. So if I load it from right here, I can go wherever I want. The power block will never spawn. Only if I load it in from the side, then that's the only way to ever make the power block appear if you use a setup like this. So then in the next step, you have basically the oldest trick in the book. If you try to follow this beetle all the way to the pipe, you will get trolled, because there's actually a one way right here that stops the beetle from breaking all the blocks until this point, so that he will already turn around earlier than you may think. However, if you've avoided this troll and then go up here, there is exactly the setup that I explained, with the same thing with the clown car and the swamp. So this time the clown car is blocked by these blocks right here, and the power block, if I stand right here, will not appear. But since I'm coming from this side normally, which is far enough off screen, you can see there's a power block right now. And all this strange setup that isn't really needed is just to make you remember that there is a power block in this room, because this is important for the next troll. So right now when you go through this door, you have to go left immediately, because there's this shelm that falls down. And this is also just to make you remember that you immediately have to go left when you enter this room. So now it looks like you need a power block. So you think, oh, there was a power block in the last room, but since you're close to it this time, it won't load, so there's nothing here. So then you will go back and you remember, I have to go left immediately. So if you go left immediately, then you'll just run into some off-screen spikes right here. And that's because there's yet another one of these teleporting launcher setups. So right here we have a bomb that is also inside the launcher. However, the first time you load the room, the launcher doesn't spawn because there's actually a block right here. But the block immediately breaks. That means if you go back into the other room, the launcher will load the next time you enter this room. And then the same thing as always happens. The launcher will suddenly teleport on top of the bomb. And the launcher doesn't even care if there's solid ground anywhere in between. And since the launcher is directly under the door, as soon as you exit the door right here, you will be teleported up on top of the launcher. And if you're still going left because you think the shell will chase you, then you will run into these trap spikes. This area right here is just to make it look like there's an actual path up here this way. So then you go down here and you get a cape. And then it says you should spin fly, which makes sense because there are swamps on the other side. However, if you spin fly, you will activate a row of hidden blocks, which then blocks your path. So instead, you will just do, or you just want to fly normally. And it doesn't even matter if you jump onto the swamps, because if you do the dive bomb, then you're actually invincible for enemies like these, and you will just start spin flying or spin jumping anyways once you hit them. And then you have to get hit once in order that you're only Big Mario right here. And this is the final troll before the second checkpoint. There's an obvious star with a lot of arrows pointing to it. But it looks like that once you get the star, there's no way out. Since I even made this track that, well, looks like there's gonna be a row of hidden blocks. And so you think, I don't even need the star, because the mushroom should be enough to make it to the checkpoint. However, that's exactly the troll, because there's an invisible block with a bomb. So only with the star you have enough time to let the bomb explode before you can actually go there and collect the checkpoint. So after hitting the second checkpoint, we'll end up in this area right here. And if you try to somehow know where you have to jump, then you'll maybe think that you can only jump where you can actually see the background piece, so right next to the spike wall right here, because you may think there's a background piece, so there has to be ground below it. But actually, this is a trick that was just recently discovered that lets you put background in the air. So if you have any of these 1x3 background pieces, then you can actually, right here, remove at least two of the ground tiles below it. If you just make a setup like this, for example, copy it and put it right there. And just like that, you have only one ground piece that is attached to the background now. And that way, I use the background right here, so you think there is ground, but there's actually no ground. Instead, you have to jump down here. And then you might think the Goomba gives you enough height to jump all the way on top of this platform. Actually, there is only the Goomba, so it seems like it's the only way. However, there's a spring hidden underneath the Goomba. So actually only by using the spring you can get up here, but since the spring is not really visible behind the Goomba, you don't see it, and so you think that you have to make this. And once you're already right here and you see the spring, it's probably too late to go back. So then you go through this door. Also, if you still have the mushroom from the second checkpoint, you will lose it right here. So then the next troll is that you think, oh, there's a swamp with blocks below it, so if I jump down there, then something will immediately fall on me, so I have to quickly jump to this spot. But actually, there's a sideways spring and a wiggler, so where really something is gonna fall is this place right here. So instead you just have to stand here in order to avoid both things. And then you're basically already at the CP1 troll. So the idea here is that you kick the bomb inside there, where it will break two blocks, one that makes the cannon fall and the other one that wakes the P-switch active. So the troll is here that you already hold up while you stand on the cannon, because you think, well, if I miss it, then I will just fall into the lava or something. So I better already hold up so that I really make it into the door. So if you're already holding up, then there's a second P-switch door, and this is the one that was right before the first checkpoint. So if you do that, then you're already back at the first checkpoint, and actually you just want to wait a little bit longer, and after you cannot go in the first door anymore, you will then go in the second door. So once you made it to this pipe, there's basically only two trolls left. The first one is the true ending troll, because it's simpler to explain. So already here you could get the eggs, but if you go for the true ending and get the flower, you're just too big to fit through this gap again, so there's no way back. And then finally, this one is easily the most complicated troll in the entire level, because it just depends on so many things. And also it's pretty difficult to try to explain what's happening exactly, because actually I can't even see it, since it's also a screen-based setup, so it only works if you load it from the side of the screen. If I stand right here, it just does nothing. It loads like you would expect it to load. However, the basic glitch behind it is whenever you have an enemy or a launcher or something stacked on top of something else, so that the top enemy is directly on a blue platform and the bottom one is directly below it, it will always do some weird stuff if you load it in from the side. So in this case, but that's also because of the muncher, the red cannon teleports into the black one, which also causes a double troll. So if you hesitate on the other platform right here and do not immediately jump to the other one, it might hit you with the potaboo that it shoots right here. So now basically what happens is, it depends on how long the top cannon is, and somewhat at that point of the height of the top cannon, the bottom cannon will float above the muncher. But in fact the top cannon doesn't go anywhere. However, if you make it bigger or shorter, it will also influence where the red cannon actually floats. So it might not be as hidden anymore if you change the length of the black bullet bill launcher. So exactly, if you have this one like that and the other one like that, it will float like right here where you can't actually see it, because it's inside the other launcher. And then for whatever reason, if you drop the platform, the entire thing just starts floating into the air and will never come back. So then it's also important that there's exactly one block of free space behind or between the bottom cannon and the muncher. If there's more or less, it also won't work. And also, this has to be semi-solid ground. If it's solid ground, like normal ground or something like that, it also won't work. And finally, these setups with the blue platform glitch sometimes don't load correctly if you're already in like a position where it slowly starts to load in and you then do some random camera movement. It might not always load as it's intended to be. So that's why I've included this big jump right here, so that in this area where the thing loads in, it's pretty hard to do any kind of camera movement because you basically have to go straight forward the entire time. Just to make it extremely unlikely that the setup doesn't load correctly. So if you have all of this together set up correctly, then it works. And that's the entire thing. That's it for today, and I hope you enjoyed the video.